A hungry teen who goes to Kroger to ask strangers for food has no idea life is about to change forever. Some people will do anything necessary to get ahead in life. One teenager decided that instead of waiting for life to happen, he was going to meet his fate head on. He headed to the rich part of town with just a bus pass and no money. He was going to do something he had never done before, but he had to do it. Chauncey Black was inside the Highland Kroger when he approached a stranger with one request that would change his life forever. Life dealt 16-year-old Chauncey Black a hand that most of us could never imagine having to live with. Although he had a place to live with his mother, he didn't have anything to eat. The poor boy was starving. So he did the only thing he could and headed to the one place that has loads of food, a Kroger grocery store in an affluent neighborhood. Although he had no money, Chauncey managed to scrounge up enough change for a bus pass that would get him there and back home again. His plan was to offer work in exchange for a bit of food. But he never expected that a chance encounter with a stranger would end up changing his life forever. Once he was inside the Kroger grocery store, Chauncey boldly approached a stranger and asked if he could carry his groceries to the car in exchange for a pack of donuts. Well, he is a teenager after all. The kind stranger, Matt White, was moved by the young man's request. This kid looked like he had been turned down 100 times. He looked ashamed, hungry, and broken. In my heart, I screamed aloud, "Yes!" But to him, I just chuckled and said, "Yeah, dude, we'll get you some donuts." Matt soon found out that Chauncey had no phone, only a bus pass, and a hungry mother waiting at home. Chauncey was depending on the good graces of a kind stranger to help feed him before his bus returned within the hour. Well, Matt wasn't going to just give the teen a single pack of donuts and leave it at that. It was apparent that the kid needed a helping hand. How could he ignore that? The Good Samaritan proceeded to load up the cart with all sorts of goodies that Chauncey could take back home to his mother. So, needless to say, he and I went on a shopping spree. We had so much fun. We got cereal and chips and frozen veggies, pizzas, Cheetos, melons and pasta, peanut butter, milk, soap, toothbrushes, just a little bit of everything. While they were shopping for all the things that Chauncey and his mom needed to survive, Matt discovered that the enterprising young man was a straight-A student, and he was trying to get a job to help his mother pay rent. This kid was amazing. Chauncey kept calling himself poor, but he told me that one day he was going to be wealthy and own his own business so that he could help other people in his neighborhood and buy them groceries like me. I was in awe. Even though Chauncey had a rough start in life, that didn't stop him from having big dreams of helping others in need. Chauncey was offered a ride instead of taking the bus, so he accepted. But upon arriving home, he and his mentally ill mother never expected the stranger to do this for them. I gave him a ride home so that he didn't have to take the bus, and when we got to his house, I was truly humbled. He wasn't kidding. He and his mom had nothing. They didn't even have beds or furniture. They were sleeping on pads made out of sleeping bags. They had two lamps and nothing in their fridge. Matt could tell that Chauncey's mother was medically fragile. She shook uncomfortably, and it was difficult for her to walk. As the pair unpacked the groceries, Matt could see hope coming back into Chauncey's eyes. It was like he was just a regular kid again. As I was leaving, I gave him a hug and told him how much God loved him and that he was going to grow up to be an incredible man. I'll never forget that hug. It meant more to me than any possession I have. However, that goodbye wasn't actually the end of this beautiful story. Matt didn't just leave Chauncey with a load of groceries that day. He set up a GoFundMe account to raise money for the necessities that this family desperately needed. Chauncey needed pants for his mother and a $10 Ross gift card for himself. He was ashamed of his tattered clothes, but Chauncey didn't just get a $10 gift card. An incredible $341,000 was raised in response to this family's basic needs. It also meant that Chauncey could purchase the equipment he needed to start his own lawn mowing business. It also meant that he could finally get a real bed to sleep in. The kindness of strangers never ceases to amaze. Not only did Matt help out Chauncey and his mother, but the response from the social media was incredible as well. Despite the large amount of money that was raised on his behalf, Chauncey still felt the need to start his own business so that he could be self-sufficient and help others. What an amazing teen!